skating championships. Now, still to come, the final competition of the pair skating and some of the ladies' short program, which is truly remarkable. Stay with us. The old country, and in your mind you might picture something like this. Welcome back from Ljubljana, Slovenia, a former republic of Yugoslavia, now a member of the European Union. The site of this year's World Junior Figure Skating Championships, Lou Tilley and Nancy Kerrigan on hand, along with a nice crowd to see the champions, the young champions of the world. Now our first look at the pairs figure skating championships. And first up, Ksenia Krasilnikova and Konstantin Bezmaternik. They're in fifth place after the short program.
They have an interesting start. They start with a triple twist, which I find interesting because a lot of the senior level skaters were doing double twists this year. And I asked why, and they said, but if you don't get much more credit, much more point-wise. So if you do a double really well, but their triple was very well done, a lot of height, so I guess it's worth it. Throw triple loop, nice and solid.
She looks young and slender. She is. She's just 14 years old. Konstantin is 17.
Side by side, triple toe loops. She missed that. And actually, the flow, she got right in his way to keep going. But they're staying right on track. Didn't seem to get in the way of the program itself. Right into the next side-by-side spins, which is really difficult for pairs to get at a young age. It takes a long time to get that synchronicity.
Got a little bit out of sync. She has been skating since the age of 4. He since 3.
It's pretty young.
Skating to a selection of Don Quixote.
She's backward outside death spiral. She's on the outside edge of her blade. Nicely done. It was held for a good amount of time. That'll gain some points for them. This system, you're trying to add the points, not take away. This is a group 3 lift. The changes of edge and the position are what give it the difficulty for the judges to be able to rank them, and that was a group 3 because he turned one way and then stopped in the middle of this lift and turned the other direction with her up above his head.
Oops.
Again, the side-by-side jumps are really difficult. She missed both of those jumps. So a lot of times why skaters go into pairs is that the singles is a little more difficult, and they often like that being with somebody else and doing the other tricks. But then when it comes back to doing the side-by-side single things, it's still
on your
difficult.
Own again, yeah.
On your own, but even more difficult, you have to match somebody. Spiral sequence step. A spiral, your leg has to be at least hip level, if not higher.
Coached by the husband and wife team, Valentina and Valery Kyakova.
This is a group 5 lasso lift, axle lasso lift. He brought her down with one hand. Really difficult to do. It shows a ton of strength. Even as little as she is, he's not that much bigger. So
right.
To bring her down all of her weight with one arm, that's very difficult. Nice position in the air. Her legs are very far back, which the better her position, the less she'll feel like she weighs for him. Pretty good match. They look a little weak, a little young. little trips here and there, but overall it was a very nice program. Well-executed tricks.
Krasilnikova and Bezmaternik, a young pair from Russia. In fifth place after the short program.
The Here, a split triple twist. He throws her way up in the air, giving her plenty of time for the three revolutions. And here, the side-by-side jumps, the double sow cow not matching. She couldn't hold on to it. And that's supposed to go right into a double axel. He does the double. She only does a single, and yet they weren't matching as well. So those, that will hurt their effort to try and get a higher ranking than the fifth place going in.
Well, you can see they're not quite in sync either as they wait for their scores. Their technical components are rather low, as you might have imagined after watching their long skate performance. And here come the scores. They were in fifth place after the short program in the World Junior Championships, hoping for a much better outcome here in the long. And their overall total score,
132,
which actually exceeds their personal best scores as a tandem over the years. So they'll set the mark in first place as of now, but still many other skaters to come. Two Americans now taking the ice, Kendra Moyle and Andy Seitz. They are in first place after the short program and really the team to beat here. They are the reigning U.S. Juniors National Champions.
You can just see in their stride and their crossovers around the ice, they're strong. They're very strong and they look stronger than the last couple, although they just did a split double twist. But it was well done, so they'll get the points for that, and I don't think it makes much of a difference. Side-by-side double axels into side-by-side double toe. Little off sync, but they're both completed. They skate faster across the ice, which is very nice to watch. Throw to the loop, nice and solid.
Kendra is 15. Her partner Andy is 20.
Here's a group five toe lasso lift. Her legs could be back a little farther. It's a tough position to hold up there, but it's a little prettier and easier for him if her legs could be a little back farther. Side-by-side double flips. This is a forward inside death spiral with him in a spread eagle. It's an interesting entrance to that. I think it would make it a little more difficult. And holding it for quite a long time makes it more difficult to get up and out of it smoothly, but they did it just fine. It was nice.
They were U.S. national ninth place finishers in 2005, but coming off now a championship back in the United States.
Throw triple sow. She was really off center in the air for that and not able to land on her feet.
Andy began skating with Kendra just about a year ago. Before that, he was skating with his sister, Lindsay.
Bringing her down with one arm, again, very difficult to do. That's wasn't seen much in the junior level years back, but now they're really pushing themselves at all the levels more and more. Side-by-side spins, they're matching pretty well, but you see they're kind of slow, and with time they'll get faster on that. It's difficult because you have to spot the other person, whereas a single skater, you just spin, you don't have to worry about making sure you're at the same time as somebody else. Little trip.
Whoops.
The spiral, just catch your edge. You never know. There could be a hole in the ice or just step down wrong. The spiral sequence. Change in the music here.
Little tango.
Looks a little tired. Took that big breath before this line sequence here and keep going. A little trip there. That's probably from being tired. You could see it right on her face. And finishing up here with a combination pair spin. They're in first place after the short, but they may be leaving the door open, Lou.
You're watching action from the World Junior Figure Skating Championships from Slovenia. And CNA proud to bring you some of the up-and-coming stars of tomorrow on this night. Here's a look back at the leaders from the United States after the short program.
There's a throw triple loop, nice and solid landing. And here, a forward inside death spiral. She's a little flat on this. She could be a little more arched in her back for a prettier position on the ice, but it's very dramatic like this. Looks like he's dragging her in that position right there.
And, of course, it always comes down to the judges, and you can see some of the tension in the faces. She's the younger of the two at age 15. Andy's been skating a bit longer. He's 20 years old. Their personal best in the long program in 84, as you can see. And here are the technical elements first, and then we'll reveal the total score.
Results from USA have ended the free program.
And she looks a little disappointed, but you know, in the fall and the throws, triple sow, it's tough because you know it's a team, and you know it took both of them for her to be up in the air, and maybe that's why got off center. But
well, this is good for first place as of right now, at any rate, Nancy. And again, it's important to note it's an all-time personal best for overall score by 4 points, and that's what you're looking for is progress. Coming up, another American team with a chance to grab the gold, and the ladies in the short program. Welcome back. Nancy Kerrigan's World of Skating taking you to the beautiful historic city of Ljubljana in Slovenia, former Yugoslavian Republic, and the competition moving on, the World Junior Figure Skating Championships. And now the last chance in the pairs competition to grab the gold. And the United States pair getting ready to take the ice. Julia Vlasov and Drew Meekins. They are in fourth place after the short program.
They were, but they have an ambitious program here, starting with double axle side by side. Well, she missed that. She went right off of her heel and wasn't even able to have a good single. It was really a little bit wild in the air. Here's a group five lasso lift. One arm coming down with one arm, nice and smooth. She has a nice extension on that landing. Nice throw, really strong landing on that.
It's a young United States couple skating out of your old club.
Yeah, the Colonial Figure Skating Club in Boxborough, Massachusetts. Nice lift, good positions. It's really important for the girl to have a good position in here. It helps so much. You can take about 20 pounds off yourself and make it you feel lighter, actually, with a good position. Good split twist with her arms up in the air, landing without having to use his hands to brace that landing. Side by side, double lutz and double flips. A little difficulty with those jumps. But look at this, nice and together on the spin. Off, but just for a split second, come right back together.
Julia's just 15, and like many skaters that we see skating under the U.S. banner now, she moved here from Russia with her parents at a young age. And coached by her mother and her father, who is the 1976 World and European bronze medalist in pairs.
They match very well their body positions. could be a little faster to this music, but you know what, when they get in these positions, look at the strength in that, right into a throw triple sow, really strong landing. Very nicely done.
They finished third in the current U.S. National Championships as juniors. And second place the year before.
Pear spin's so interesting. They start out and it has such speed, and then when she pulls out like that, it really loses speed. Then you get it back together, and it's an interesting spin. It was very different when I competed in pairs. There was no coming apart and coming back together again like that.
You're back competing in pairs again, aren't you?
Yeah, I did skating with celebrities. Very interesting. Look at this. He goes one direction with the lift and then stops and turns the other way, which is really hard to keep the center for her as well. But coming down forward, which is almost unheard of for skating, because coming down forward, you have that toe pick right in the way, and that makes it a little more difficult. Circular footwork. And her back outside death spiral. Interesting position. Changing arms for him to keep it going.
They really slow down and lose pace though during this program.
A little bit, but you know what? Their elements and their movements and their tricks were really strong and solid, and I think we're definitely going to see them moving up.
And you can see they've really laid it all out, as we like to say in sports, particularly the younger Julia Vlasov, as we look back on their long program.
Look at this coming down. Nice positions. When he brings her down, they match very closely. Ooh. Puts her up in that lift and then right up into a throw triple sow. Very nicely done. Really strong on the landing.
Julia Vlasov and Drew Meekins, and the father and the mother coaches here as we await their scores. In fourth place after the short program, but as you said, the door kind of left open here, and a chance to medal on the world stage at the World Junior Championships. They finished in third in the United States Junior Championships as pairs. So here are the numbers, 92.61 in the free skate, and they add them up.
Yes!
And you can see they jumped all the way from fourth to first place. Julia Vlasov and Drew Meekins of the United States, now the World Pairs Champions. So here are the final standings. The United States flag flying in three of the top four slots around the Russian. Vlasov and Meekins passing Moyle and Seitz to capture the World Championships.
The United States has often had difficulties with pairs in the past, but it looks like this group may help change all that.
Now,
World Junior Championships are a great place to see the future stars of figure skating. This event has everything. Talent, drama, emotion, and winning an event like this can give an athlete the confidence to take their skating to a higher level. Congratulations to Takahiko Kazuka for taking first in the men's competition, and to Julia Vlasov and Drew Meekins for their come-from-behind victory in pairs. In our next show, we'll take you back to the World Junior Championships for the women's long program. As usual, the U.S. fielded a talented team that included Alyssa Sisney and Christine Zukowski. So be sure to tune in for part two of our coverage of the World Junior Championships. For CN8, I'm Nancy Kerrigan. Thanks. See you next time.